सर।
ಎಲ್ರಿಗೂ ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ ಹಾರ್ಟಿ ವೆಲ್ಕಮ್ ಟು ಜ್ಞಾನಾರ್ಜನೆ ಎಂಪವರಿಂಗ್ ಎಕ್ಸಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಟುಡೇ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಜಾಯಿಂಡ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಟು ನೋ ದ ಮೋರ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ನ್ಯೂ ನೆಟ್ವರ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ಗೈಡ್ಲೈನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಐಸಿಐ ಅಂಡ್ ಕಾರ್ಪೊರೇಟ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸ್ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಟು ಎನ್ಲೈಟನ್ ಅಸ್ ಆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸೆಷನ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅವರ್ ಓನ್ ಸೆಂಟ್ರಲ್ ಕೌನ್ಸಿಲ್ ಮೆಂಬರ್ ಸಿ ಎ ದಯಾನಿವಾಸ್ ಶರ್ಮಾ On behalf of Bangalore branch and on behalf of all the participants here and on behalf of all the panelists here, hearty welcome to Dayaji. Hearty welcome. Friends,
thank you, Dr. Thank you very much.
Sorry?
Thank you very much.
You are welcome. You are welcome. Friends, we are happy to have our regional council member, Geeta AB, is with us. Hearty welcome, ma'am. Friends, to make this session more interactive, we have welcomed two other senior chartered accountants. CA Sanjay Dhariwal ji is with us. Hearty welcome, Sanjay ji. We also have our senior chartered accountant, Chandrahasa Kannadka is with us. CA Chandrahasa Kannadka, hearty welcome, Chandrahas. Friends, our branch secretary, Divya. And I think our another SARC member had to join. With that note, once again, hearty welcome to all of you. You are the reason for this program. Let us understand more about new networking guidelines of ICAI. Before that, I'll take a minute or two of yours. We have many other programs lined up in this month for the benefit of our members in this pandemic time. So on 18th, day after tomorrow, not day after tomorrow, after that, on Tuesday, 18th of May, we have arranged a 3 hours CPE session on ticking, from ticking to clicking of businesses is on 18th May. It's a 3 hours from evening 5 to 8. So maybe you must have received a message wrongly at 10 to 1. Please, I'm correcting it. It is evening 5 to 8 on Tuesday, 18th. Again, this program is going to be free. It's a CPE program of 3 hours. Please register so you can elevate yourself to business consultant or business advisor. Basically, that is codenamed as from ticking to clicking businesses. The area he is going to explain, our senior faculty and experienced person in that line of business, business consultancy and business advisory. How a chartered accountant can become a business consultant or business advisor is going to be learned on 18th, Tuesday, 5 to 8. Please register for that program. Again, on 20th, we have arranged a 3 hour CPE session. It is going to be free again. It is a 3 hour session from morning 10 to afternoon 1 o'clock. It is on professional ethics and Ind AS. So senior faculties are going to impart their knowledge. Please register for that program. Again, on 27th of this month, 28th, Friday evening, 5:30 to 8:30, we are arranging a new amendments in Schedule 3 of the Companies Act and its impact on the CARO reporting. So that CA Guraj Acharya is going to impart his knowledge on that. It is most demanded seminar. Many members asked me for that, and hence it is fixed today itself on 27th, evening 5:30 to 8:30. Please join for that program. Again, that program is going to be free because of pandemic. We have all many programs made it free. But on 24th, 25th, 31st and 1st, 4 days workshop is there, wealth management. It is, we are charging nominal fees of just 400 rupees for 4 days workshop. Please register to that program. It is very, very lucrative area for chartered accountants, wealth management. Please register for that workshop. With that note, many other workshops and programs lined up for the month of June also. Please regularly visit bangaloreicai.org. Coming back to this networking, friends, I thought networking is a most important thing to happen because we need to grow up. We need to make bigger size of firms. In that regard, Bangalore branch already taken that initiative. In our website, we have already created a networking tab. many members already registered there and they have shown their interest where they want to have the partners across India. So friends, networking tab, I request all of you visit bangaloreici.org and look into networking tab, register yourself. You can look partners across India. It is my humble request to our Central Council member Dayaji, he is involved in this networking. I request him to take this across India in all the branches also. They need to create that kind of tab so that Bangalore members can see Cochin website and see that whether I am getting any partner there. So Bangalore members already showing there are 20-30 members already registered, including me. I also looking for many various partners across India. So I have mentioned this. If I am compatible for Hyderabad person, he can contact me. Only email ID I am showing there. So he has to contact me. Yes, if you are interested, I am very much lucky. So that is the idea actually. So it is definitely helps this way. That is the reason Bangalore branch is taken that initiative. I have mentioned this in our All India Chairman group also. But I think if you take that initiative, it will happen across. At least in major branch, wherever website is that, in all, I think every branch has a website. If not there, at least whoever has the website, make this tab. It is not costing much. If require, I can share our technology partner to them. So bargain for the price and we can make a nominal price for that. And he can make it across all the website so that it is very easy to network across India. So that is the need of the hour, according to me. So we need to make the firms bigger through that mode. Later, yes, our president also said later best parties merging together, making a single firm. That may take a little longer time. But immediately everyone can have a networking with the proper guidelines from the ICAI. With that note, once again, hearty welcome to Sri Dayanima Sharma, our Central Council member, and all the panelists, including Madam Geeta and other panelists. Hearty welcome to you once again. And members, you are the reason. You are the reason for this program. Hearty welcome to each one of you. Over to Divya.
Thank you, Chairman. A very pleasant good evening to all the panelists, speakers of the day, and to all the participants. I would like to give a brief introduction about our Central Council member, C.A. Dayanivas Sharma, Managing Partner of Lakshmi Nivas & Co. Chartered Accountants, Certified Information System Auditor and Certified Forensic Auditor. He is also Chairman of Peer Review Board, Chairman, Members and Student Services Directorate, including SSP, Vice Chairman of Digital Accounting and Assurance Board, Vice Chairman of Financial Reporting Review Board, Board Member of Quality Review Board, Board Member of XPRL India, Member of UDIN Directorate and Digital Transformation Process Re-Engineering Group, Chairman of Center of Excellence Hyderabad, Member of multiple Central Council committees. Also, he is C.A. Dayanivas Sharma, qualified CA in the year 2005, articled with Price Waterhouse. Thereafter, he revived Lakshmi Nivas & Co. from one member to 130 staff firm and contributed to more than 100 plus CAs to the fraternity. He has also been recognized as Young India Visionary by IMV Innovative Media Group in whole of UAE. At ICA National and International Forums, he has taken sessions and seminars on more than 23 plus topics. For this very brief introduction, I welcome you for today's program, sir.
Thank you, Divya. Just a minute, sir. I request our SARC member, Geeta, madam, to speak a few words. Over to Geeta.
Good evening, everyone. I don't want to take much of the time because we are lagging behind the time. I'm happy to inform you that recently we have collected, along with KCA, Bangalore branch has collected a few funds to contribute to this oxygen concentrators. So I request the members to contribute generously because it is a need of our, and we know so many. Even including CEs and their families are affecting with this COVID, and there is a lack of oxygen concentrators. And recently, when we donated the oxygen concentrators to MP, he also mentioned because that is the lack of because of this oxygen concentrators, people are suffering a lot. So I request all the members to generously come forward and contribute to this noble cause. Thank you.
Thank you, Madam Geeta. So today also we have sent out that donation request mail to all the members. It is again my humble request to all the members to contribute generously for that noble cause. Thank you very much. Over to Dayaji.
Thank you, respected chairman of Bangalore branch, the largest branch in the country as such. It's actually indeed a pleasure to be, you know, coming to Bangalore and sharing my views on the new networking guidelines. You have been working very hard, chairman, during this time to keep everyone engaged and ensure that, you know, people are going through a learning experience, diverting their mind from the pain they are going through, might be directly or indirectly, which is itself a you know, a very positive contribution from your side. Thank you, Divya, for giving the introduction, and it's indeed a pleasure to, you know, interact with you again. Geeta madam, thank you very much. You are also doing a great job in the SIRC as well as in Bangalore, which itself is a new beginning in more than one ways. Sanjay bhai, to talk before you is like talking before an elder brother who is a guru, kind of a guru featured person for me, who is actually guided in more than one ways. And the most important part is, you know, the way you speak straight to the point. And most important part is, you know, being human, the way you have taught me in my continuous interactions with you from last 7-8 years on a continuous basis is something which I'm always thankful for. And really, you know, you get the humanity in us in when we share, when you share particularly time with, you know, the experience with us. So please continue doing it. We need it now and again, every time. I think till the time we don't get mature to your level. And Chandra sir, thank you very much for being the panelist today with me. And, you know, both of you are knowledgeable, and I'll try my level best. Whether I have prepared well for the networking guidelines or not, you know, your questions and my answers, I'll try to justify. So with this, friends, first of all, a great evening to you all who are joined us today for this interesting topic. I'm today telling you interesting topic. There are many reasons behind it. You know, I'll at appropriate time, certain important events which have taken place with all these networking guidelines, and we have close to 100 plus firms, out of which, you know, the networking firms, out of which one of the most successful model is no other person who is sitting on the screen, is Sanjay Dhariwal ji, who is running his networking also very effectively. And I think a lot of people are getting encouraged, and I got a lot of inputs from his way of doing, and that is what I have incorporated, Sanjay bhai. To be honest, you know, that is the way we have learned and moved forward. My entire presentation, Shetty sir, I intentionally just modified to a level because in 2019, Mr. Shivram Bhatt invited me to Bangalore, if you remember, in the hall. So I left one discussion at one point. I am today starting my discussion from that point only, because whatever thoughts I gave when I got into the council in 2018-19, that thoughts are actually becoming reality in more than one ways. So what I want to do is, I want to give this presentation in two or three.
Please increase volume a little bit. I think mine is wrong, or?
Yeah, I'll just, Sanjay bhai, is it audible? Yes.
So you're audible, sir.
Yes, okay, yes. Fine. Mine may be low,
Yeah. So Shetty sir, I'll start the discussion from there. And most important part is, this entire presentation I have divided in three parts. Three parts is primarily one on the statistics, where we stand and the globe stands with regards to our understanding and what vision we should now create from 75 years what we have come. I think 75th year of our independence should give independence to our mind that, you know, how we have to transform and make it big. And right time has come now. It is like, you know, in past it was early, but now it is the time. So that is the first part, is the statistics. Second part is the global, you know, scenario. And third part is basically the networking guidelines, and most importantly, the corporate form of practice. And I was a little surprised when I was speaking in Mumbai study circle, one of the very senior member told that I have never heard the concept of corporate form of practice and how successful it is. And I was also surprised when I started talking about corporate form of practice in Hyderabad. The first person to do was Sunil Appaji, whose number is 0001 for registration of corporate form of practice. So this is the, you know, gap which is there. So we are just trying to pull out the treasures and we are going to discuss. So I'm just going to share my presentation. Hope you all will like it. And most important part, friends, I would like to say is you all have to participate in this entire discussion. That will be the biggest, you know, gaining point for me to, you know, and any kind of questions you have, without hesitation, I request you all people to ensure that you deliberate, you note down your points, and wherever the question answer session is there, you can put it. So, Shetty sir, if you remember, this was the slide which I made when I came last time to Bangalore, and it was from local to global. And yes, there was a discussion which we had was new age audit firm. So yes, I just converted this into creating big Indian CA firms. And this is something which I'm going to share with the statistics of the global audit institutes across the world. And people will really get to know what is the kind of difference we are actually seeing in this entire process, right? So emerging professional opportunities is undoubtedly the fact, and networking, corporate form of practice with mergers. So the concept I am going to take you through is the 360 degree view. And I would like to, before I start my presentation, Shetty sir, I would like to thank on behalf of all of us to all our past president and past council members who had vision to think about the networking guidelines. And you will be surprised to know globally, there is no institute which has this kind of corporate, networking guidelines or corporate form of practice, which has been placed on record and the way we are moving forward. So multidisciplinary firms, we are going to talk about it. Don't worry. Now, these are all the statistics which we are going to discuss. And this is worth noting. Everyone, whoever is sitting at home on a Saturday evening, have a nice cup of coffee before you, hot, with some snacks, and listen to this discussion. I promise you, it will be a different, thought-provoking environment, which if doesn't happen, you only have to tell me that this was not a great thing. So I'll agree to it, and I'll modify my presentation at a later point in time. Let us see the realistic numbers of our profession, which is very, very important. If you see on 1st January 2019, our membership, which was reported, was 2,73,000. And on 1st January 2021, we have done, I am the convener and the chairman of Member and Student Services. You will be surprised to know, after the SSP coming into place, we could actually get all the statistical data together, and we analyzed, including the deceased member, the total number of members which are on roll of the institute register is 3,87,110 members. So this is a big number. When we go in further discussion, you will understand. And because of SSP, lot of new statistical information started coming to us, and that is how this presentation I am actually able to make before you. Example, let us take what was the number of ACA and FCA. In this percentage, you can understand what and where we are standing. Like ACAs was 66% in the old one, which was 1st January 2019, versus the current has become 68, means 2% have increased, 2% in FCA has reduced. Similarly, with regards to COP, friends, this is good and bad, I can say. COP holders were 1,31,000, which is, after number of CA as per SSP is 2,51,000. Because people, if you've seen Shetty sir, lot of large firms may say people have moved out and started practice. We are seeing always one small set of practicing members who are the same people, but there is a new breed of chartered accountants who started coming and taking in the COPs and started moving forward in a different direction. So that is something which is very, very good. Non-COP, if you see, these are the numbers, right? So just remember these numbers. Next. This is the statistical, data of our institute, which sometimes I feel is little alarming or little more alarming than what is being expected. If you see the number of COPs which is increased, actually the increase in proprietary concerns have shot up if you actually look into the aspect. So the fact has been the number of firms which are more than 51 in this country, 51 partners in this country is only 10. I am actually going to come back to the networking. Please don't worry. I am setting a tone for all of us to understand where we stand in the entire statistical framework and what is the bigger opportunity which we are missing out, which we are not actually exploring. Let us see the example. One, which is a proprietary concern, is 62,000 firms are registered. And today, Shetty sir, one more thing you see, the Reserve Bank of India new guidelines has actually talked about two partners or more. And it is slowly eliminating the proprietary concerns, which has been now represented by the institute. One thing which I like to tell you, friends, this I am talking to you in the capacity of Dayanivas Sharma, Chartered Accountant. I am not giving any view from the institute point of view what is happening, but I am just trying to share where we are moving towards. Even in case of concurrent audits, now proprietary concern firms are not being considered in more than one ways. They want two partner firm with DISA, with this, with that and all. And slowly the branch audit, if it is going to get eliminated, that means concurrent audits or might be a different kind of audit which is going to evolve and it is going to come before us in a different form. But again, what I would like to say is it is an alarm which is actually being raised by Reserve Bank of India, new notification or new circular which has come for the appointment of auditors, where they are talking about eliminating the proprietary concern, which everyone might have criticism, doesn't matter, but it is a third party regulator, that is their view which is there. And most important part is about 51 partner firm in this country, we have 29 states. And out of the 29 states, you are actually, please understand, we don't even have 29 firms which are more than 51 partners. Can you just imagine? If you see in China, please go back and check it out in China model. In the China model, the top four, top six, top eight are Chinese firms, not the global big firms. Where are we heading? Now let us understand this factor. And there are many common points which we have deliberated in the networking guidelines, which I'm going to talk to you. Where have we gone wrong? We tried to assess how things can be improvised by considering certain limitations which are being placed in the firms, in the existing guidelines of networking and any other forms of merger that we were talking about. But you see, 11 to 15 partners also, we have 288 firms only, which is actually 0.33%, which is not even 1%. Please remember these points, these numbers, kindly just remember. I am going to take you through something very interesting discussion. After these slides, there are going to be something very, very lucrative discussions which are going to have. Non-COP and full-time practice, you can see 381,000, how it has been divided. Right? Now let me take you through this slide. Earlier, Sanjay Bhai, we were not even getting to know what is the total number of certifications which are been happening, right? Which are been happening by the firms in India. One second. By the firms in India, we were never getting to know what are the kind of certification, but only I'm really thankful in my first year of, council, I was made core part of the entire UDIN directorate, which were three member people. And we could actually shape it up so well, where we are able to analyze where our profession is moving towards. Friends, this is something which is need to be looked in very seriously, very seriously. Now, when you talk about the limited review reports, which have been signed in whole period of 1 year, were close to 50,761. Internal audits, 65,000. Concurrent audits, 2,05,000, right? And then statutory audit of non-corporate. Shetty sir, remember, it is non-corporate entities, means partnership firms and trust or other things, right? In the current scenario, there is a change which has come, which I'm going to talk about. Statutory audit of corporate, 7,17,000. We have close to 8,50,000 companies, and there might be some defunct companies, this, that, and all other which have been there. I hope, Sanjay bhai, this statistical information is making some sense.
Yes,
it is making a lot of sense, and it is also opening our eyes now.
Yeah, so my point is, Sanjay bhai, why I got this all numbers is because 2 years back, we were never knowing what actually our practicing firms are doing. And today we don't want to regulate with UDIN. Please understand, friends, all of you, I'm telling you, we don't want to regulate anything from UDIN. The UDIN mechanism is only to protect that. Yes, chartered accountant has signed this. So we are not going to take any other discussions and way forward in this matter. So now you see the corporate entities, we have 7,17,000. In next slides, it will be alarming numbers, which I am going to share with you. You will be shocked going forward. I am assuring you, you will be shocked. And where we need to plan and strategize our firms is something which we need to really look into. Miscellaneous category under audit is close to 3 lakh, right? Out of this, I just have bifurcated what is GST and tax audit numbers. Just see this, 3CB is 26,26,000, right? 26,26,000 UDINs are being generated for 3CB numbers. Now my point to you is, when the government has come forward to increase the threshold limit, of tax audit, what this number will be, just imagine. And where will we be heading our practice towards, you just imagine. Number two point is, in case of GST audit, GSTR 9C and all, we raised, Sanjay bhai, you are expert of GST. I want you to see that number, 11,98,000 UDINs are being generated only in one year on GST. And now we don't have GST audit, right? So what is this giving a message is something which we need to really question and evaluate, analyze, and plan how our practice has to move towards. Because some more alarming numbers I'm going to share with our friends. But one thing which I would like to tell all chartered accountants who are attending this seminar, friends, nothing to worry. Time again and again, revolutions have come and moved. And it is time where income tax audit got really matured. We all know that. GST audit, we got it matured within 3 years. And today, the statistical data, Sanjay bhai, with all due respect, our chartered accountants have done the data entry operator almost for a nil cost to the government to ensure that the GST framework is perfectly successful and moving good. Right? We underpriced ourselves in GST. And more importantly, tariq pe tariq, if you remember Damini dialogue, it is the same thing which has come for our chartered accountants. Tariq pe tariq, date by date, our extensions have happened in GST, and no client has paid you 3 times to work on the same engagement. You agree or not?
Agree.
Shetty sir, you agree as the chairman of the branch? So we never got 3 times the fees, but the dates got extended. Clients used our time. You have left your families in the house. Night, 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, corona, staff, no staff, article examinations is there or not. We burned our blood like anything, and we did that entire setup of GST. And now that 11,98,000 is gone for a
task. Two things I would like to add here, Dhyabhai.
Yes,
one
sir.
Is this 11,98,000 could include for 2 years of a GST audit, which was done in the last year only. So this could be actually 6 lakhs only.
Chalo, 6 lakhs. Probably. Yeah.
Yeah. So and the second thing is, you are talking about 3 times fees. I think even 1 time fees we have not got.
So this is where, now you remember, Sanjay bhai, this point, which I would like to reuse this discussion in the next coming slides, right? Till hope till here, all the members are with me. I would like to see someone writing in the chat that they are there with me, or I am actually running fast. If anyone can give their feedback, I'll be really grateful. Not there. Let me listen to some people, sir. Correct, Ashati sir. Then we'll understand that people are actively listening to the entire discussion.
One point, Mr. Sharmaji, the 3 CV figures are so likely to come down.
Sir?
The 3 CV figures, 26,26,069, you're showing.
Yeah.
They are also likely to come down.
Sir, you are 100% right. I am going to take certain very interesting slides going forward. Please note, it's going to be very, very interesting. Sir, one thing which I'd like to say, Sanjay Bhai, Chandresh sir, and BT Shetty sir, I am not scaring people. I am just trying to figure out where our practice has to move towards and how the new avenues are to be tapped, rather than thinking about what is going from us. See, income tax stayed for over a longer period of time. Now, what is going to happen in times to come is, with your GSTR, Sanjay Bhai, right? Your income tax return is picking up all the turnover which is written from the GSTR, right? So there is a looping of laws which have happened. Sometime I'll try to share, you know, how the laws have transformed and interconnectivity between the departments, which never used to speak to each other. Income tax department never used to speak to VAT department. VAT department never used to speak to, central excise or whatever it is. And ESI, PF, to forget. So now the entire laws have now been connected. So friends, just remember, this is not a number given by me. This is the UDIN generated numbers. If anyone has missed out, it will be few in hundreds, not more than that, right? Now let me take you through the next slide. The next slide, what is being always been done? How have our practice, this entire thing, I am just putting forward in a very simple chart. If the huge world opportunity is there, our focus was primarily on internal audit, statutory audit, Companies Act, Income Tax Act, GST audit. Maximum was bank audits, right? Now bank audit, jhatka, you are already seeing. Corporate finance, which very few people are able to do. Direct and indirect tax representation has become faceless. And you and I know the reality behind this, how people are going to fight for it, how they are going to move for it. That is a big question to be asked. But one thing which I would like to tell you, Shetty sir, in 2018, the budget of 2018 talked about faceless assessments. And everyone laughed at the budget, saying that it cannot happen. September 2019, they mooted an idea and 7,205 were scrutinized facelessly. And that entire thing is now made as a faceless assessment, which you all are seeing, which we all are seeing. So within a time of two to two and a half years, the accelerated mechanism of, the adoption of technology, whether by choice or by force, has actually come to the government as well as our members. That is a reality. If this pandemic would have not come, I think this growth would have not been there to that speed with which it is there. Like Ind AS, some people have been doing systems audit, which I would like to talk sometime later. When we have 28,000 chartered accountants who have qualified DISA, and 280 people are also not in practice of system audit, which is today's the requirement. Today is the requirement. Just imagine why I told you I am thankful to our past president and past council members. They actually done a very far-sighted approach. Now it is 18 years, system audit is in place. How forward-thinking was our council? Just imagine. How forward-thinking was our institute? Just imagine. But today we have only 280 or less than that people who are into this. Now let me take you through one of the most interesting slides. 7 continents, 195 countries, 162 accounting bodies. Shetty sir, do you know that in Mauritius, Indian chartered accountant can sign balance sheet?
No, it's news. No, no, I'm not aware.
And there are very more company countries in which an Indian chartered accountant is allowed to sign. Point number one, sir. Point number two, I did an entire reading. I also was not aware before getting into council, because when I got into council, I read the entire act of Chartered Accountants Act, and then realized there is no restriction for opening a foreign branch anywhere in the world by a chartered accountant firm. Are you aware of this?
That is also news for us.
Thank you, sir. I'm happy that you are reconfirming where I was standing. So that I don't have that guilt feeling. Sanjay bhai, you are aware?
I was aware.
You have to read the entire act also. Right? Now, what I want to do is, with this, I want to take back to the discussion slides which we had, and you will understand the comparability between an Indian chartered accountant and a foreign chartered accountant. So, Shetty sir, this is a new addition from me to the members today. Only for Bangalore, I had to prepare this slide and come, because if you see my old slide, this will not have this all information. CPA Australia, US, we have 6,64,000 chartered accountants. ICAI, 3,87,000 chartered accountants. China, they are less than us. Canada, 2,17,000. Right? Australia, 158. ICAEW, the oldest institute of the world, it has 1,81,000 members only. Singapore, 32,000. 1,20,000, Australia and New Zealand. There is another institute there. Right? Now, I ask one question to you. This is the population of our country, and compared with China and globe. Now tell me one thing, 3,87,000 members in a large country which is having 17.9% of the population of the world, right? Versus, I would like to ask one thing, Singapore, 32,000 members only in such a small country. Australia, you see, size wise it is big, population wise it is very small, and 1,58,000 members, even not at all comparable, right? You know what is the difference between them and us in India?
What are their areas of practice?
Same.
They also do audit and assurance.
Yeah, they also do audit and assurance. They also do tax. They also do federal tax. They also do state tax. They also do internal audits. They also do variety of forensic audits. They also do everything like us.
The major difference is basically the people who are paying the taxes. We are hardly at 3-4% of the total population, and over there it's more. So obviously the requirements of audits and companies would also be higher.
So Sanjay bhai, the point is very simple. Now by looping of laws with GST coming into existence, if you see the number of people who are going to come into tax bracket is going to be high because of a subsuming of multiple laws, right? But the most important difference which we need to notice that they are a small country with almost same size of chartered accountant plus or minus, but they charge not on annual basis, lump sum basis. They charge on hourly rate basis. And their rates, our institute has announced certain rates, which in our own internal competitions, we are underpricing ourselves and we are killing ourselves. I'm sorry to use that word, but that is a reality. We are underpricing. Even GST was a right time to reprice. Forensic audit is the right thing to reprice our profession. ASM services, right time to reprice ourselves. You know, Satya Shetty sir, in Mumbai, for 14,000 crores worth of advances, an ASM agency was being appointed for 50,000 rupees per month. If this is the size of undercutting which we are going to do, who is going to protect? That is one important factor. This also is basically from a point of view, the population size, which I was talking about, right? Now, most importantly, let us come to this slide. I want you to go back to that UDIN site, which I gave the statistical information, and the smallest economies of the world and the largest economy of the world. I am talking about smallest is basically countries like Singapore, Malaysia, Dubai, or a country like Australia or United States of America. There is an audit exemption which are there for them. And under the current GST regime, we are actually moving towards that side only. Please take it from me, if people, this is my individual opinion. It is not institute opinion. Again, I am telling you all, it is my individual opinion. But I am just putting forward to before my friends that, you know, this can come tomorrow. And we are seeing those days to actually happen, where even there is a deliberation which is made in corporate of Ministry of Corporate Affairs, where they are not public in linked interest entities. Why do you want to get it audited? Now, example, in United States of America, the bottom line which I am talking about, audit requirement in US, there are no legal requirement for a privately held entities to audit financial statements. Just imagine in United States of America. Now, when you go to country like Singapore, if the turnover is less than $10 million, or the asset size is less than $10 million, or the employee count is less than 50, I need not do an audit. Now tell me, in case of this number, now you remember this, right, Shetisa? I'm just taking you back in one slide. Now you relate that exemptions with this data. Is it leaving you with some kind of thinking that where we need to plan our profession going forward?
Really scary. That I am advocating since beginning of this year. So we need to move away from this, our traditional practice or audit and assurance practice. We have, that is the reason we continuously conducting various new avenues of practice. So people are slowly realizing and attending such programs.
Correct.
So things will improve.
So Sanjay bhai, I hope this statistics makes some sense in my discussion. You are a senior member. Chandrakas sir, you also have to give your input if this is the right direction which we are moving in, right? Rather than only talking about networking, I should actually tell why we should do networking. And these are all the fundamental things which we have to keep it in mind before we move towards this next slide. The first and the foremost thing is the difference between who you are and who you want to be is what you do. I think all of us will agree that time has gone where individual proprietary concerns were able to survive very effectively. But today, in the proprietary concern, getting an article clerk also has become a challenge because they come and ask, what is that you are going to teach me? So it is time that united in diversity is the concept which we need to think from a point of, okay, I don't want to do a merger. Let me come together to work, understand each other, and see how we can move forward in a true spirit. So friends, the concept of networking, again, I am thankful to this council, which has given this kind of vision. I tried exploring whether there is a networking model, which is there in any other institute in the world. I could not lay my hands. And if you think that you are able to lay your hands, I'll be really thankful and grateful if you can share me that discussion paper or whatever paper you get, right? So my thanks to my council who has agreed to go this. Now my entire network, there are four concepts which we are going to talk about. One, networking guidelines. Two is corporate form of practice. Three is merger and multidisciplinary firms, MDP, what we call, and MRAs and MOUs. Shetty sir, Sanjay bhai, one thing I would like to say, MDP practice was initiated long back in this, by MCA, where they told that Chartered Accountant Institute, CS Institute and CW Institute has to come together and sign an agreement, agree for, doing a multidisciplinary practice. only the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India has agreed, made the amendment to the law and actually introduced. Now the Ministry of Corporate Affairs has forced all the institutes to make their amendment in the act and allow this multidisciplinary practice a reality in times to come, which has already been initiated. I am going to talk when I'm going to come on the particular slide. So the fact is, just imagine how forward thinking as our institute has gone to actually think about the multidisciplinary practice. I'll just quickly touch upon the multidisciplinary practice before we get into the networking guideline. In the multidisciplinary practice, it talks about, you know, all the forms of professions can come together and form an MDP. That means a chartered accountant, a cost accountant, a company secretary, lawyer, engineer, valuer, you know, any person who is a professional who can get associated with the chartered accountant and he can become a member. Earlier, our restriction was there with regards to acts, that act, CA act, that we can only do a partnership with a chartered accountant only. But in MDP, you can actually do. And fortunately, our council was very, you know, forward looking, which is approved. And in SSP portal, which I am heading now, we are actually getting all the forms of all these four forms and five forms. Merger is already there. We are getting in as an online process. It will become a triggering of button and initiating the entire process. Now, let me take you through the networking guideline. The preamble, the concern relating to the growth. Can you just imagine that we had deliberation of 21 long meetings, 21. And the 21 long meetings, the concerns of relating to the growth of Indian firms has been deliberated at length. Why networking and three models, what it is going to be, we are going to discuss today, right? Hope till here we are together. Now I am taking off to a very important, And now let us enjoy the ride with regards to the networking guidelines. Just imagine 2005. We have introduced, as I was telling 16 years back, we have introduced the concept of networking. And 2011, there was a revision. But again, this revision had certain limitations which were there, which I am going to talk about. And 100 networks were being formed at the national level. And unfortunately, friends, one after another stopped working because of various reasons. That is where the third point comes. ICAI has noted the bottlenecks in networking and has tried to mitigate the same in the revised guidelines, which we are going to discuss at length today. So in the 397th council meeting, which was held in Kumarakom, Kerala, 11th January, first final discussion has happened. And then the council discussed about certain very important aspects, which I would like to talk about before we go to the networking guideline. There are a couple of points which are very interesting. Shetty sir noted notable point here. Just note down this thing. ICAI can consider providing model deed for this networking guidelines. We are going to provide a model deed how your firms actually.
In fact, we are waiting for that.
Modify. Yes, we are actually starting to work on this. Then should resemble the name of the firm, which is the criteria which we are going to discuss. But the most important part is, you know, the brand name of the network, Sanjay Bhai, worth noting, brand name of the network which you are going to register should be owned by an Indian citizen only. Okay. So that means if tomorrow there is an international networking which is going to come, international firms which are willing to come, we want Indian firms to be showcased rather than the international firms. So the reason of owning the international brand name with the Indian citizen is that. And the beauty is in this networking guidelines, right? You can do the networking or alliance, whichever you want, as a joint venture to execute a specific project also, like an AOP, right? You can actually have a joint venture for a specific project and then you can dissolve that network. Number three, the most important part is we have deliberated in council, why not this network be allowed a independent status also? If Sanjay Bhai wants to convert his network into AOP, Sanjay Bhai, worth noting point, today you cannot take work on your network firm, right? So yes. Now what we are telling is networking can actually apply for association of person, create a separate identity, and non-attest functions can be taken on the network name also. I hope you will like this approach in totality. And can prepare your financial statements of AOP, share the revenues accordingly with the network firms. These are all the kind of deliberation which has happened in Kumarakom, and this entire incorporation has actually been finalized in the 398th meeting in the month of February on 2021, saying that yes, I am giving the thappa that you can go ahead to do all these things.
Our SARC secretary also joined for your interaction.
Namaskar.
Thank you, sir. I am there from the beginning itself. Yes.
Hearty welcome, Panraj. But you joined as attendee. We sent a panelist link. Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Panraj, sir. So, Sanjay Bhai, just imagine the kind of wisdom we have applied to tell that, you know, the attest function should lie with the firm only. Non-attest function you can take on the network which is formed AOP. Point number one. Point number two, and then I can distribute my revenues to a respective firm in the way AOP does it. Point number one. Point number two is basically, which I told you, if you want to pitch in for a very large engagement, you can form an exclusive network for that particular engagement, execute it, dissolve it. This is something which is very, very different, which we have put forward for our members, friends. So I hope you will like this, right? Now, what are the concerns which we noted? Some important concerns. Majority of CA firms are SMP, which you can imagine with the 62,000 firms, which is 70% representation of the entire CA practice, is actually an SMP, which is a proprietary concern. Large number of firms have confined practice to audit and taxation, which you will agree. Many firms have audit allotment through ICI PDC, which is nothing but CNAG, RBI, concurrent audit, different kind of empanelments, which is there. So most of the firms are only thinking that, I want my firm to be empaneled and I'll get my engagement accordingly. So this was one of the major concern of the growth of Indian CA firms. Attachment with the first name, firm name, means I should have my own name. I don't want other name to be incorporated. But when we want to make it as an institutions, and today no one owns the large firms, no one knows who are the owner of the large firms. It is basically a person has to become larger in life to ensure that, the firm's representations have to be made larger. Unfortunately, we have actually tied up, which is a realistic, discussion which we had, that attachment of the firm name was a point of concern. And fear of loss of identity, which I don't know why people have that. Yes, there might be instances. Client switches over to large firm when his business needs increase. My question is one thing which is very clear. There are a lot of complex laws in India. People want to expand to international. We do not have that kind of capability. Obviously, when we want to do something large, the large also wants someone large to come and support them. It cannot be a situation that I'll only sign balance sheet or I'll sign only income tax audit return and I am going to conclude this. Sir, I might be talking some realistic facts which is hurting someone. My sincere apology, but it is my duty to, share with everyone what my individual views are. So you might like it, dislike it, might be later on you will like it. That's the only thing which I'm trying to make it. And anywhere, if I have heard any sentiments of any person, my apology at this point in time only. But the important factor is, let us be realistic in the entire growth story of our firm. The last one is basically need of RE's to venture into non-traditional practice areas, specialization, and form large structure of network. I might have a client which is expert in, I'm doing a statutory audit. But if I have to go to Sanjay Bhai, Sanjay Bhai can actually guide me to reach out to, you know, Bangalore. BT Shetty sir might meet guiding me to reach out to Mangalore. Pannaraj sir might expand me to Singapore. Another friend of mine might take me to somewhere else. So when you are going to get into a network which is going to be spread across the length and breadth of the country, and more importantly, international, as I told you that you can actually have international offices. There are a lot of people, close to 5,000 chartered accountants are working in Dubai and UAE alone. And globally, we have close to 50,000-55,000 working across the globe at the length and breadth of the world. So the need of ours is to enter into non-traditional practice. As I was telling, tax audit, GST audit, statutory audit, which might go, which I don't know, but GST audit or tax audit, you know the fact what has happened, right? Now, the most important part is this step so far outside the comfort zone that you forget how to get back there. This is where we need to really think about. Let us think, how do I move out from my comfort zone of doing my traditional practice? And it is time where we need to explore certain things new and different and deliberate among ourselves. And Bangalore is known for forming small, small groups, which is very, very strong in their entire bonding, sharing. And I know Sanjay Bhai and his all friends who are in indirect tax, they sit together, deliberate together the problems, and ultimately when they face the client, they become larger than the problem. Matlab, they are, you know, unlimited people, and never anyone recompeted or cross-competed with their own clients till the time that situations have come. Please understand, when that kind of situation exists today, why do we have to live that? Am I right?
Agreed.
So Sanjay Bhai, Bangalore is, I always have that, you know, good feel good factor to always be part of one or the other Bangalore group, you know, which is actually operating at the, you know, a different level altogether in learning experience. Now, the reality in, we all remember the tough words which are being spoken by our Prime Minister on 1st July 2017 when GST was being launched. We all remember that. But do we all remember that he also talked about 100 big Indian firms? How many have us actually aligned with this vision? Think it over, feel about it, and then let us deliberate. If you see the picture which I have placed, that picture also speaks about if we small people come together also, we can become a crown of a king. That is how we need to look at of coming together and showcasing that we are larger than an individual. We are actually a group of huge number of people, which is actually a big size that cannot be broken. It is a fantastic opportunity of pooling of resources, expertise, combined strength, and showcasing pan-India presence. This is something which we need to remember. And most importantly, why networking is required. Time has come where we need to invest on technology, right? Example, if I have to buy a server, that itself will cost me 5 lakh rupees. As a proprietary concern, can I buy a 5 lakh rupees server? There are many firms which are able to do, but youngsters or some seniors, or whoever, if I have to have my own domain name, or I have my own mail ID, or I have my own cloud server, can I buy a small cloud server? Yes, I can buy, but again, there will be a compromise. But by coming together to form a network, we can actually pool up our resources to make it more larger than what is expected. If you talk about the transfer pricing certificate, that software itself, it costs close to 7.5 lakh rupees. Might be it is not, you know, right for a, even if you tell me to go and buy 7.5 lakh rupees worth of you know, software, I am not in position to buy. Yeah. So if we are 10 people coming together, just divide that 5.5 lakh rupees with 10 people, 55,000. Yes, I can contribute and pull out the resources. People, I need not hire every type of people in my firm. My firm might be good in audit. Sanjay Bhai firm will be good in indirect taxes. Shetty sir firm will be good in foreign trade practices. Pranarath sir firm is very good in you know, any other services. If we are able to pool up people, I need not spend money on people. I need not pay huge amount of salaries. Today the problem is, if Sanjay Bhai does GST audit, no one is there in his office. Example I'm giving, not that way, to do a statutory audit or internal audit. In my firm, it is statutory audit, internal audit, but no GST audit. And in case of Shetty sir, I might have tens of clients which are doing export, but his experience is not there. Just imagine if I pool all my resources and I say I'm a firm of 1,000 people. Just imagine to say 1,000 people, what will be the power of your profile? That is what I want to tell people. The next part, just telling I have assets. How many computers, how many, you know, buildings of our own? We have 15 branches or 15 associate firms or 15 network firms in different parts of the country. Just imagine those assets will be pooled together. The softwares will be pooled together. And as I told, many such things can be incorporated. The advantage of these three things converts into optimization of my cost. I need not spend from my pocket on a continuous basis. Service line will increase. Today I might tell I'm only a statutory audit firm or internal audit firm, but tomorrow I'll be in position to tell I have GST expert, I have foreign trade practice expert, I have foreign branches expert, this, that, and everything. And the most important part is, where we chartered accountant miss out, is market penetration and development. Because I was individual, I was alone, I was not able to get into the market, I was not able to do the deliberation with regards to development of my firm, because once I get three clients, I don't have time to do the fourth client. This is the situation where we have gotten. So the reason of coming into a right network is primarily from our pooling of all these things, and many other advantages are there. And friends, the most important part, the nutshell, is today organic growth is not possible. Today it is only inorganic growth with which we can move forward. You see, any mergers, any acquisitions, any investments in any form of corporate world, you will see only inorganic growth only. It is not a possibility that we can grow organically by adding people after people, people after people. That is one message which I want to say, only to leverage what we want to do in a larger interest, right? So till here, I hope all are together with me.
Yeah.
Right? So shall we continue, sir? Any questions are till here? Any points you would like to add, Sanjay Bhai or Chandrasekhar sir?
Mr. Daya, you said that we can showcase that we have experts in different fields, but our institute doesn't allow us to showcase officially.
No, officially nahi, Sanjay Bhai, but it doesn't restrict you to form and profile of your firm. When a client wants, you can actually share that. See, today the problem is...
Can we share the network's total profile now? Legally?
Yeah. Now I am going to talk about this. Very nice point you touched. Thank you very much, Sanjay Bhai. Thank you very much. I am going to talk in my slides to come. This is where the interesting part is going to come. Right? Any other point which you would like to share? Chandrasekhar sir?
Anyway, sir, I think the questions I will take at the end, because most of the points are to be deliberated.
Sure. So till here, I have just created a background of why networking guidelines are there.
No, in a lighter note, so if you have network across India, you can travel across India. Many of us not seen all over India, no? You as a Correct. Central Council member, you traveled across. We might have gone Europe, not Northeast.
One more point, Mr. Daya. You can also add on that you said that sharing of fees can be done in the networking. But yes, attest sir. Functions cannot be done in the networking. So if the attest function is done by the individual firm, can that fees be shared with the network? That point also.
Yes, sir. So now let me tell, Sanjay Bhai, you have actually, aapka vision itna jada hai that you actually walk ahead of time. And that is why I love you every time, and respect for all this knowledge. Because all these points are actually being deliberated in this model which we are going to start discussing. Most of the things are same. I am only going to touch upon in the first slide what is it, and then going forward, exceptions which are there in every form of network, right? So after taking off, now we are getting into the realistic approach. We have created a beautiful model for all our members, which is called Approach 1 and Approach 2, which is Model A and Model B. Model A is the concept which is called Alliance Model, and Model B is called Network Model. In Model B, we have split into two parts. After law, one is network of firms and another is network firms with a lead firm. There are three concepts which we are deliberating today, and it is very interesting. All the three has a different reasoning, and I am fortunate that, you know, this proposal which was being given, one was being given by one council member, another two are being given by me. So I'm really delighted and happy to share with you, you know, that this is actually moved forward very effectively, right? Different firm come together to form an alliance with a new name of alliance and continuing to practice independently and can showcase as an alliance to the whole world. This is, you know, we are all working independently, but I am only putting it as an alliance, which I'll talk about it detailed mein aage. Now, the second part is different firms coming together to form a network with a network name and practicing in the name of firm belonging to the network, which is divided into two parts. Network of firms, right? This is an existing model which is there, and the new firm, which is, this is new model, which is B2 called as lead firm model. There is a very thoughtful, you know, discussion which has happened in this, and I'm going to share in my next slides. We need to remember these three R's. Sanjay bhai, it is really worth noting, and hats off to Atul bhai, who was the president last year. He introduced the concept of word called 3 R's in the entire networking guidelines, which is actually this: register, recognize, regulate, right? In all the three cases, we need to get registered with ICI, which I'm going to discuss at length. Here, the alliance will not get a recognition. It will be registered, but not recognized. Bhai, tum tumhara sabka kaam, tumhara kaam kar lo, but you are actually together. And partially regulated, what it means, we'll deliberate in the next slides. Right? Versus registered to be recognized. What does this to be recognized means is by the government of India. We are initiating a process to ensure that this network guidelines are going to be recognized by CNDG, RBI, you know, talk about SFIO, this, that, any regulator for that matter. We are moving an agenda. We have already shared with MCA to recognize this and forward it to the all other ministries to make it with the dream of 100 Indian firms of Prime Minister dream. Very simple, right? So these 3 R's we need to remember. We are going to discuss in times to come. Now, the first model, Sanjay bhai, all your questions will be answered here and going forward in the slides also. The purpose is for mutual benefit. What is alliance model is, firms come together just to say that we are all firms, we are working together. Aaj bhi, we go and tell in the market that, you know, we have an associate firm. But this doesn't stand valid before anyone. What associate means? See, we have used it effectively, but later on it got diluted where people were getting associated. I was getting a work for 10,000 rupees for stock audit. I was giving it 2,000 rupees only for an associate firm. And it was not being moving forward and the quality was deteriorating. So then we realized one fact, why not we get all these people together and get it registered? Because they can later move to network. What is the difference between alliance and network? We'll discuss. The name and style can be ABC and alliance or ABCD, whatever name you want to put. It is only a name of 4 firms, which is in line with the existing naming guidelines of ICI or and alliance. This is the important factor in this. Next is alliance registration number will be given by ICI to you. Most important part is you can continue your firms as independent practices. they are no way linked, only apart from, yes, we are working together. Display alliance name in the professional stationery to be permitted. Sanjay bhai, now all your letterheads, your visiting cards, your sites, everywhere you can put that you are a firm. And if you want that name is like your alliance, which is a network which is there, which is spread across 20-30, just turn your card, put ABC and alliance and all the city names behind it. Letterhead pe aap rakh sakte hain, envelope se rakh sakte hain, firm ki website pe rakh sakte hain. There is no restriction on that. Then alliance mein direct constituent firm to allow best practice. It will only direct. When I create an alliance, I need to form a document, MOU, to form it together, to sign it, to be a member of that alliance. And in that particular thing, they can only direct, saying you have to follow the best practice. Versus in networks, we are going to discuss something else about it, which I'll tell you. Multiple firms. Now the point is, if I am a member of an alliance, I cannot become member of another network. If I am a member of a network, I cannot become a member of another alliance. I have to be a member of any one, right? Number two is basically the eighth point. All the firms can independently empanel with the regulators, whatever they want to do. But only reason is to do why we are coming together, to do a non-audit service. Example, Sanjay bhai, you have a statutory audit of a very big company in Bangalore, which has an office in Hyderabad. And you want me to perform an audit here, right? Based on your guidelines, not my firm practices, your guidelines, I'll complete the audit work here, hand it over to you, and you are going to sign. I cannot sign anything. This is the meaning of this, right? Apart from that, next one, independence that need to be maintained, which we don't want to compromise and dilute. Where I am a statutory auditor, you cannot become internal auditor. Where you are internal auditor, statutory auditor, I cannot become internal auditor. Right? So these are, and non-attest functions also are very critical. So the purpose of coming together is for doing mostly the non-audit functions. Example, I got a stock audit. Yeah, example, I got a factory visit. I got something else, or might be any other thing apart from audit. The best advantage is for the alliance. Now, referral of professional work and sharing of fees and cost permitted. I hope, Sanjay bhai, now you got your answer here.
No, my answer was whether the new firm which is constituted as a network firm, whether they cannot do attest functions. So the firm A, which is a partner, is an attest function doing it. So can they share the fees with the network per se?
Yes, they can share the fees per network. Not a problem. That I am going to discuss in the network side, but I was thinking you are referring to this. So the
even otherwise, mutually chartered accountant can share the fees. No, there is no issues.
No issue. And here in India, is basically the reason of getting it together. Tomorrow there should not be any confusion. So what we got is, in the alliance model also it is permitted. The partner of the firm gets appointment, will sign the report here. You are only assisting them, or you are doing any non-audit for work for them. Firm responsible for delinquencies, the firm which is actually taken the assignment, or the firm which has performed the job, that person only will be responsible, not the entire alliance. Not the entire alliance. It is very clear. Code of ethics, as usual, will have to be followed. Any firm is allowed to enter and exit alliance at any given point in time, but that entry or exit should be a reconstitution, and that should be noted with the ICI, right? Work completion, if one firm leaves the alliance, the other firms can complete the regular work. And the most important part is bylaws that need to be framed up by all the alliance, and they have to come together and sign that as a MOU or an agreement or a bylaw, what you talk about. You can do it, and you can actually form an EOP for doing alliance model also, right? Now let us go to the networking, which is B1, right? Here, Sanjay bhai, when compared to the old network to the new network, the beauty is there in this, right? The beauty is, it is coming together for pooling of resources, showcasing their combined strength, and have, which is important, and have uniform policies technologies collab. मैं आ रहा हूं, माई फाइलिंग प्रोसीजर्स, माई डॉक्यूमेंटेशन प्रोसीजर्स, माई मेलिंग प्रोसीजर्स, ऑल काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स हैज टू बी इन अ पर्टिकुलर फॉर्मेट बिकॉज वी वॉन्ट टू मेक अ स्टैंडर्डाइज फर्म विच इज फॉलोइंग ऑल द बेस्ट प्रैक्टिसेस पुलिंग टूगेदर. दैट इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट इन दिस. वी वॉन्ट पीपल टू कम इन टू अ सिंगल मॉडल फर्म, देन ओनली द एडवांटेज विल कम. अदरवाइज one firm, one branch will talk about something and we will talk about something else. Right? Here, the nomenclature which can be name style which can be used is ABCD, ABCD and affiliates or ABCD network. Followed with the network registration number also will be required. And the most important part is network decision prevail over other firms. This is the most important part which is there, Shetty sir, Sanjay bhai, that the guidelines which are going to be framed for making a standard firm. Because today people, when the client is interacting, they don't want to see a different mail coming from your side, my side, or any other side. And you can also have a beauty about this is, you want to create a network, mail ID, and buy a network, saying that abcnetwork.com. You can do that. So that it will become a standardized approach. All my signature patterns, documentation patterns, filing patterns, query patterns, all are going to be same. So network decision prevail all the firms is the model which is there. All firms belonging to network can apply for empanelment separately as individual firm. In this particular case, B1 model, all the firms can independently apply. They can independently apply. The recognition which we were talking about with CNAG RBI is going to be, if there is a large audit which is there, example, and all these firms are eligible to be called as a network firm, then if they want to give small branches to that network to have a uniformity, they will get the recognition for that purpose to come together and they'll be getting allotment of audit in totality. You get my point?
Sharma ji?
Sir?
Can we get one point clarified here on the name?
Sir?
That the affiliates, if they are ABCD, even in the revised guidelines, it is simple example is given that the name can be ABCD and associates, ABCD network, that fashion. That is generally understood. But you mentioned in one point that the network can have a separate brand name. Can it be different from this ABCD, a totally different name?
No, sir. This, no. Because this is a guideline of ICI.
Right.
So you cannot have a...
I think name. In Model 8 is possible.
Yes, because sir. We have ensured
that... get a clarification from you. If the name is, see, now three firms are coming together, one say for example Govind Associates, one NBC and Company, one Kirti and Vivek LLP. How to combine these and make a meaningful name will be a challenge. That's why you mentioned a separate brand name. If that is available, that will be a good thing for all these network firms.
Sir, the only problem which is there now, sir, we had a deliberation. What was happening is the naming style to define out of this naming style is going to be very difficult because some person will say Sri Venkateshwara and Associates, right? Some person will say Balaji and Associates. Some person will say Roderick's and Associates. So the point is it is going to become a very difficult name to...
That's why if they are allowed to have a separate brand name, as you mentioned earlier, for the network only a separate name, need not be of all these mixed combinations.
Mr. Daya,
sir,
I think earlier you had this concept of the network having a separate name and affiliates using their own names. And you had that multi names being put into the visiting cards.
But after that they have removed it. But yes, I can take this feedback. If almost all people will agree, then I'll take this feedback to the council again for considering this particular thing. Right?
Yeah.
So all the firms belonging to network can apply for empanelment separately in individual name. The advantage will be something different in times to come. Then here, when you talk about 16th point, if you see, because all others are going to be same. 16th point, if you see, it is quality control is well documented and complied with. This is something which we want the firm to get into a standardization process, following the best practices. So the draft document which we are going to share from the institute in time to come is actually going to give you that minimum criteria which the MOU should have, and accordingly you can actually draft it so that the best practices can be followed. Firms will be bound by the network's integral integration agreement. This is the word which is very effectively used, so that when I see any file of my network, I should feel like it is one firm. Let us take an example of a bank, right? If a bank is there, we go to one particular branch, is same interior, two branch, same interior, three branch, same interior. You go to any international or national, you go to Van Heusen showroom, all showrooms look alike. Kind of thing where we want to get in all those people to come in one particular framework to make it big. Individual firms take up professional work on their own, and partner of said firm can sign the report or document. Right? I'm just going to take you to the most important part now here. Right? This is all we have recognized here. Point number four is something which is very important. Constituent firms are bound by internal agreement and recognizing one of the firm as a lead firm. Recognizing one of the firm as a lead firm, depending upon specialization expertise required by each assignment. That means, one, I'll take a lead firm and accordingly I'll take it forward. If I want to know my firm as a, you know, merger and acquisition, and I want to make that branding as that, and that firm where all the other firms are going to come together and align. Example, I am IPO oriented, I am MSME related, or I am doing something else, foreign services, whatever it is. If I can tell that, okay, out of this 10 firms coming out, this will be the lead firm, and this is going to go for all kind of empanelments. So technically what is happening, there'll be a couple of questions which will be coming in your mind, which we are going to discuss. Empanelment process, lead firm is entitled to apply for all empanelments, right? That means other constituent firms cannot apply, right? A partner of a lead firm will sign the report or certificate. And the most important part, which I would like to share with you, is, the 15th point. If any firm leaves the network, and particularly that lead firm leaves the network, the clause to that effect has to be incorporated into the agreement that the entire fees which has come because of the united effort need to be shared in the proportion of their agreed upon agreement. If the lead firm leaves the firm and they have taken the assignment, assume I am the lead firm, I have taken the assignment, I am leaving the network and going. So responsibility of the lead firm to share that revenues with all the constituent firms. This is the important clause which we have incorporated, so that over a period of time when it is there with them, let it be with them, but they have to share the money. All compliance. Bound by internal network, individual firm can take up work on their own, and partner of said firm can sign the report and documents. That means the lead firm is used for some other purposes, but I am a constituent firm. I can actually take my engagement regularly, whatever I want to do, and I can do my audits, consulting, this, that, and all other. There is no restriction. For the purpose of empanelment, for the purpose of showcasing, if I want to pitch in for a larger assignment, this agreement, this lead firm model will be effectively used. Example, in case of Mumbai, if there is a firm which is doing mutual fund audits or bank audits, or might be if it is doing some stock broking audits, so that firm can be a lead firm, and the other constituent firms can actually focus on developing some other area. That is all the discussion. How is this content paper? There is a book which has actually been made out, which is this one, which I request everyone to download. There are all the questions which are answered in this book, which is there on the ICI site. The para one outlines the purpose of revising the guideline. Para two identifies the concern which we have discussed at length. Para three is about the need of network, which we have discussed at length. Offers three model, which we have discussed.
You are not audible. Hello, Dayaji, you are not audible. Hello.
Is it audible now?
Yeah, now fine.
Now fine, right? You heard the previous.
No, document? last minute, you have to repeat.
So this slide is with regards to the new guideline paper.
Not visible.
Just a moment, sir. Is it coming now?
Yeah, now it's coming.
Now it's coming.
I'll stop sharing my video because network might be some problem. Now it is clear, right?
Okay. Yeah.
So the content of the new guidelines which I was showing with you all people was the paras which have been explaining what it is, and the most important part is the content of this guideline paper is, first, all the following three models of network are been explained in this. Each of these three models have their own appendix, which is clearly defining, and each of these have their own forms, which are very clearly designed for the registration purpose. You can even today need to be done manually, and another 2 months time, this entire network model, hopefully I'm putting my fingers crossed, to get it on the SSP portal. So that will be one of my biggest challenges. And peer review also, we are trying to get it on the SSP so that the entire one single platform will be the concept of ICI in times to come, which we are trying to work on, right? Then corporate form of practice, this is the part B. So part A is with regards to the entire networking guidelines, which we have deliberated all the three models. And the three models, as you are aware, why networking is required. If you remember that circle always, which I shared in the before discussing the topic, you will really get to know the logic behind it to make a large India firm. Sanjay bhai, what has happened over a period of time, lot of mergers and demergers have taken place in the recent past in an aim to grow the firm. Shetty sir, you will be surprised to know that lot of people have moved towards merger model, but due to some or the other reason, they were not having that comfort to work on. And the networking guidelines was not so promising to get people together. So what we thought is, let us get a concept called, live-in relationship, which is a boyfriend, girlfriend on a lighter side. Then your engagement, which is primarily the networking model, which is B1 or B2. And then your marriage with regards to mergers. So what will happen is, if 3 or 4 years people stay together to work together, the advantage will be they'll understand them each other effectively. And one point in time, they'll get into a merger model. That is the aim with which this entire new networking guideline has been introduced. So alliance model, I want to keep myself independent, network partially independent, and B2 is again regulated to a greater extent, right? So these three are being discussed, and any questions we'll be taking up in our Q&A. Now let us go to the corporate form of practice. This corporate form of practice also is one of the most interesting part. 2016 was the time in which the corporate form of practice was being introduced by our institute, and nowhere in the world this concept exists. Nowhere in the world, no institute in the world. So we have actually defined thinking lot of limitations, because when you talk about corporate form of practice, a partner alone cannot get money into the firm. And then I want to create a corporate entity where I can actually get some kind of investment, shareholding, because in a partnership firm, I cannot partner, right? With any non-chartered accountant. Whereas in case of corporate form of practice, this is the most beautiful part which we need to really understand. Retain full-time COP. I can retain. Shetty sir, you can retain your firm. You can hold your COP and also be a managing director of the company which you are incorporating, which includes LLP. LLP, private limited company or limited company, doesn't, there is no restriction as such. You can actually form a company and retain this. No restriction on quantum of equity holding of the member, either individually or along with his relatives in such company. So relative destination, you can take it and you can actually get a lot of investment in the company, and also you can make him a director, right? Such member shall be regarded as being full-time practitioner. Example, if you are not holding your certificate of practice, right, which I gave in the first example, you own a firm and you own a corporate form of practice. Example, next second suggestion is, you don't have a firm, you want to only own a corporate form of practice, still and holding COP, right? You can train all the articles as per the guideline. Only thing you cannot do is that you cannot do an attest function in the corporate form of practice. That's the only change which is there. Example, you want to take investments, you want to do, make it big and Shusha kind of thing, you are allowed to do that. Entitled to train articles, as I was telling, name of management consultancy company also is as per the ICI guidelines. MCA, neither to be permitted advertise or use logo. The purpose of this is, we have retained the sanctity of the Professional Guidelines Act, which is there for not doing advertisement, non-solicitation of work, not using logo. Now logos can be used for a specific purpose, which is actually again in the code of ethics, which is very clearly defined. Now earlier, if you remember, we used to only put a black and white board. Shetty sir, correct? Now earlier, we used to only use black and white board. Now you can use a LED lit board. That is the kind of difference which has come. So sometime we'll actually go on the advertising guideline of the firm also. There is a lot of new changes which have come. And the most important part, Shetty sir, which I would like to tell you is, you were talking about a tab of networking which has been made on the site of Bangalore branch, right?
Yeah, networking tab is there available in our site.
Yes. So Sanjay bhai, just for your information, I am really happy and proud to say that I am part of that group. Hope I am audible.
Yes, you are. No, not
visible.
Yeah, you're audible and visible.
चलो तो आपको देख के इसलिए बोलना चाह रहा हूँ के लाइक बीएनआई लाइक व्हाट शेट्टी सर इज बीन टॉकिंग अबाउट वी आर कमिंग विद अ न्यू कॉन्सेप्ट व्हिच इज कॉल्ड सीए कनेक्ट इट इज टू बी अ मार्केट प्लेस फॉर चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट्स वेयर यू कैन लिस्ट योर फर्म नेम राइट विथ एवरी पार्टनर कैन एक्चुअली हाईलाइट टू एरियाज ऑफ योर एक्सपर्टीज location where you are, what you are. Example, I am in Hyderabad, I am a company and would like to sort out based on the experience, the number of partners, number of articles, number of team which is going to be there in the firm, what is the area of expertise, and all those details. I can, if I am a Hindustan Lever ka CFO and I want to see which is the firm which is operating in all the states, I can just pull out everything and that person can get in touch with you, and it is going to be a different ball game in time to come. Just, I cannot talk more than this. Very soon we are launching that beta version of the site, and everything has been tested, proved and moved. So now we are putting our fingers crossed to ensure that it is launched very soon. So there, a lot of things are going to be discussed and deliberated at length.
So one question in that corporate form, you said logo cannot be used. Whether we can use that CA logo also in CA logo in that corporate?
Yeah, form? That you can use, sir. That you can use. That's not a problem. That's not a problem.
Okay, thank you.
Right.
So already existing company can be changed to that, whatever the required in that. It is possible to convert it, or new company to form.
New company only have to be incorporated. There is a guideline which is there in detail. how you need to apply. You need to take the, I'll just quickly tell you the guideline. What it says is you need to apply for name availability, write it to the institute. Institute, look, this is the name availability which I have got. If you permit me, I'll go for it. And the object clause of that private limited company should be in line with this management consultancy services. And once institute say yes, you can go and get it registered. And then this data should be shared with the institute. And you can move on with all your discussions and work.
And salaries can be paid for the partners or the directors?
Yes, sir. Salaries can be paid for directors. Yes, sir. Not a problem at all.
That is a salary income or a business income?
Salary.
Salary, no, sir. If it is a salary, if it is an LLP, then it will come as a, yeah. If it is going to LLP, then you can take it as a share of professional income. And this share of professional income will not disqualify if your income is more than the income coming from the firm. It will not be disregarding you to empanel anywhere. It will be combined and it will be treated as one single professional income only. Okay, fine.
Thank you.
So these are all the criteria which are there where you can actually go for management consultancy services, which is now updated. Now the next part is with regards to merger demerger. As I told you, these guidelines are known to everyone. I'm just going to quit, complete because we are almost close to 8 o'clock. Merger and demerger guidelines stand as it is. And the beauty is in the entire merger demerger can be now done through SSP portal. Last year, people were facing certain difficulties, but all the difficulties have been removed. And you can happily by click of button and generating OTP, you can merge your firm or demerge from any other setup. And the most important part, which I discussed, multidisciplinary practice, which is going to be a reality. I think start working on this part in times to come. It is a future of our profession, friends. Please don't take it light. It is going to be one of the most interesting avenues for our profession. You will make it big. That's the only message which I can tell you. Start working with lawyers, start working with, bar counsel is not permitted till now. You can work with valuers, you can work with engineers, you can work with CSCS and form a multidisciplinary firm, which can be showcased in a very large manner. So it is going to be a new avenue for all of us. The most important part, which I would like to say, is going local to global. I'll be happy to share with you this thing. You have 37 international chapters, 27 international representative offices, and 2 permanent offices globally. And more importantly, we have signed 19 MOUs and MRAs across the length and breadth of the world, where by writing 1 or 2 exams, you will qualify to be a chartered accountant of any of these institutes, right? Which is already an existing MOU, MRA signed. Please take this initiative and move forward. Just an example is Canadian, which I was talking about, a chartered accountant qualified member of ICI and remains registered with ICI as a member. This is the most important part. Number 2, ICI member are exempted from practical training module, Capstan 1 and 2, if they have more than 2 years of experience, post-qualification experience, or more than 5 years post-qualification experience without a recognized degree. Pass the final CPA module, 3-day common final examination in physical format only. So Sanjay Rao, just imagine by writing only this paper, right, final paper, you will be equivalent to a CPA of Canada, right? Similarly, you are talking about South Africa. You see how easy they have made it. And best part, Shetty sir, to note, they have diluted their passing for us, but we have not diluted our passing. They have to write all the exams in our case, barring 1 or 2, right? That means the power of ICI is larger than these institutes. That is what I would like to share with you, right? Let me take one more example. UK, a qualified chartered accountant of ICI, pass ICIW advanced level examination and complete ICI ethical learning program. By virtue of this, you become a qualified chartered accountant from ICAEW, world's oldest accounting body. Australia, we have the similar kind of thing. And we have so many other countries where we are actually entitled to do different kind of programs with our institute itself. Today, by getting into these international bodies, just imagine the profile what you are going to have, that you are a CA from ICI and also you are CA from Australia and New Zealand. There is a pathway program of ICI New Zealand. I'll tell you one thing. In Hyderabad, a very dear friend of mine by name Srikant, he moved to Australia, wrote two papers in Australia. Today, he is practicing in Australia after writing those two papers only. Just imagine the kind of learning and earning experience he has gone through. It's amazing. It's amazing. And all these are being signed, not now, years together. Where are we moving towards? Why are we thinking that GST and income tax is only our life? There is much more cloud computing, which has actually become a reality where we all started using cloud, right? Even in last year audit, bank audit, you have used all the server model, this model, that model. When you are going to get connected with the institute members there, they are going to give you a lot of work which can be done. You will not believe 40% of Deloitte's international work happens from Hyderabad alone with 40,000 employees. Can you imagine? All the audit work is happening. Now we are initiating one more process where Dubai audits will be happening in Hyderabad. There are so many things which we can talk about and length. I have limited question then. The opportunities which are there, which today is not a discussion, so I'm just cutting down. I'll be sharing this presentation with all. So friends, I ask you one simple question. If I want to run a firm as a proprietary concern, this is where my life is going to be. If I come together, I can actually win the match. And I always take this example for only one reason, Sanjay bhai. Tell me, where is Mahendra Singh Dhoni here, who's won the World Cup for us? In this entire photograph, you will not see Mahendra Singh Dhoni because he was playing with his daughter in the ground when all the people were lifting the cup. Time has come where we need to come unite together. It is not a matter of I am a captain or I am not a captain of an organization. It is basically winning is important. And professions cannot win independently. We are only going to sit alone in the entire large setup of country like India. Right? So my request to you all people is this one. It's time to come together. We all have power to change. So what we are waiting for? Think it for a while. What we had discussed today, I have shared certain sentiments, certain important statistics, and certain realistic targets which we can achieve without getting into any other discussions today. So friends, I thank you all for giving me an opportunity to come here and share with you my views with regards to networking guidelines, way forward of our profession, and more importantly, coming together will make whole lot of difference in each and every person's life. Tomorrow, when an article is coming to you for getting that article registration done, today articles have become demanding. They ask us what work you have. Tomorrow, when we are doing network, we can say that I am a global or national network, and imagine what is going to come for our, on our fold. So with this, I thank you all for giving me an opportunity to come and share my views with you all people. I hope I justified my being here and tried my level best, Sanjay bhai. If anywhere I have gone wrong, my apology.
There are questions in chat box. Then please answer those. Then our panelist also have many questions.
So where is the chat? In the chat box.
Can you repeat the questions, Mr. Shetty? That will be faster.
I saw only one question in chat box. I can see that. Does this overseas qualification allow CA practitioner to sign, attest, perform audit functions in other overseas country also?
Very good question. So in this particular case, some MOUs and MRAs permit you to sign there. Some MOUs and MRA tell you to go and complete a portion of learning experience. You will be qualified, but you might have to do another portion of practical training or something like that. So once you do that, every MOU and MRA has a different set, but qualification is the most important part. So you qualify and you can actually, once you want to apply for the practicing this thing, you need to do an additional bit, which is very small. You need not go through the entire process again.
Yeah, one more query for me only. It is on 18th program, whether it is at 10 a.m. or evening 5 p.m. Sorry, it was printed mistakenly in newsletter and some other place also. Apology for that. And it is 18th program is evening 5 p.m. to 8 p.m. Evening 5 p.m. to 8 p.m. When you go to the registration, it is clearly available there. It is 5 p.m. to 8 p.m. Okay, please register for that. Then another question for Adayaji. What are the guidelines for multidisciplinary partnership form?
The guidelines are being, I'll tell you, the guidelines are being approved by ICAI and that were being placed with the Ministry of Corporate Affairs. What Ministry of Corporate Affairs did was they called us and they wanted to check with us why this is not getting implemented. So we said that we have changed the act in totality and we are ready to it. You have approved the act and which is agreed. So what they asked is, okay, what is the problem? Then we said we want the sister concerns also to adopt and other bodies to come and adopt. So what happened in the month of February was there was a public exposure which was being done. Public exposure was being done by MCA. And MCA has taken it and now they have finalized the entire thing. And the guidelines is almost now, you know, draft guidelines are there, which I can share, but it is not too a reality, not too far a reality that we are going to get the final ones also.
Yeah, one more question, I think, regarding those statistics. If UDIN generated multiple times for the same audit, the same is considered for the numbers. I think that is for your statistics purpose. Yeah.
No one actually generated. Aray, sir, people have forgotten to generate UDIN. Who will generate multiple UDIN?
Okay. Two more are there. Today, fintech has become a very interesting opportunity for chartered accountant, but a practicing CA firm cannot make use of the opportunity as there is no option to share fees, profits with software engineers.
So you can actually now do it in the corporate form of practice, as simple as that.
You don't have the concept of sharing on percentage basis. That's a problem.
No, not sharing on percentage of basis. I don't want to talk more. If chartered accountant has to think about, they'll confuse. I'll whoever that member is, they can call me. I'll guide them. Sir, there is no stoppage to the growth. I think it is basically we have to evolve and move out of the regular thinking pattern.
Another one is there, but it is not full. Daya sir, suppose there are 100 firms in network. One firm from one city has referred work to another firm to another city. Further, nothing is there. I don't know. What is that?
I don't know.
Anyway, I think we'll move forward.
Shetty sir.
Yes.
Shetty sir, I have a couple of questions which have been shared to me, to my mobile. Can I read it out only? Two, three questions?
Yeah, yeah. Please go ahead.
Sir, good evening. Yes, sir. Sorry, I was not having that. Sir, first of all, I thank Daya sir for making the online platform of SSP into reality. Because of that, even in lockdown period also, our institute work is going smooth and all members are enjoying that one. Thanks a lot. Thanks for that initiative taken by you. And one more thank thing you, about UDIN. So because of that, yeah, even our professional fraternity is getting our unique identity because otherwise we were facing some problems with the non-CAs practicing in CA's name. Thank you very much, sir, for that.
Thank you, Geeta madam, for recognizing the efforts which I have put in because, you know, the council members carve for taking in at least two words of appreciation every time. So I'm really thankful for, giving me, sharing your views here. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. First of all, the both the models naming almost all same, even both can independently apply the B1 model and the alliance model and the B1 model. Both the models naming almost all the same, and even both in both models, the independently, the firms can apply for other audits. Then what is the difference? What is the even naming also, naming pattern also almost all similar ABC and affiliates. It can be worked out for the both the models, first model and second model, affiliation model and the other model. Then
alliance has a different model altogether. It has to be put as alliance. So the first model will be having alliance, and for the network B1 and B2 will be network or affiliates or network. Right.
Okay.
Madam, the point which I would like to tell you, I understood your question. The point which I would like to tell you, why did we introduce these three models? As I told you, it is basically a live-in relationship which is called alliance, right? Which we generally use in a regular life, right? Where we are coming together and we are getting recognized only to the extent of my registration is being done, right? That, you know, we are all one firm in the sense when I want to pitch in for anything. Whereas in case of network, the major difference is the empanelment process also will get impacted. And more importantly, the fact come as a one single firm, one big firm, means my entire practice should be, I don't want to name the big names here, but would like to say that my standardization procedures have to be single.
Okay. Sir, you mentioned about the corporate practice model. In that, only the CEs can be the managing directors of the company, and whether they can advertise.
No, I told the advertisement again. There is a new revised advertising guidelines which has come. So that, to that extent, you can advertise, and beyond that, no.
Okay. And can the
again, madam, one thing I'll tell you for all the learned members. See, we have to maintain certain ethical requirements of a practicing chartered accountant, which is very important. We should not solicit for work. Example, we should not do advertisement to get work. But there are some other limitations which are being killed because of the corporate form of practice. When I'm telling that I want to take a new investment, I want to get another people in the entire board. So all that process can happen. So don't only see from the advertisement point of view. There is much more which is available for doing it large.
Okay. The next question is, can the multidisciplinary firms also be recognized by the other professional institutes?
That is where the point is. MCA has put inside now, and they are telling both the other institutes to agree for it. And you will be happy to know, Geeta madam, our SSP portal is already started working on registering, creating the forms, how the data should be collated for multidisciplinary firm. Shetty sir, this is a very challenging work. Just imagine, as a chartered accountant, I have membership of my all institute under itself, but we are going to pull the data from other institutes and other bodies. Itself is going to be a different challenge when we have already started working on it. So by the time government announces in totality, we will be ready with our software.
Okay, sir, that's it from my side, sir. Back to Shetty sir.
Unmute, sir.
Sanjay, you can proceed, and then Chandra Asa. I have a few more questions. I'll come back to later.
Okay. This is in continuation of Geeta ma'am's question. If it's a multidisciplinary firm and it is recognized after all the formalities are being done, can it be taken as part of the networking firm? Because I think even today the institute says that I cannot share my fees with others. This would be an entity which is trying to have multiple people, whether I would be able to do that.
ये वाला पॉइंट हम लोग नहीं लिए, लेट मी बी ऑनेस्ट, बट आई विल टेक अप दिस मैटर एंड आई विल एंश्योर दैट इट इज फ्रॉम माय साइड टू एंश्योर दैट कॉर्पोरेट फॉर्म ऑफ प्रैक्टिस आल्सो शुड बिकम और मल्टीडिसिप्लिनरी प्रैक्टिस शुड आल्सो कैन बिकम अ नेटवर्क और अलायंस दैट वी विल टेक इट अप वी विल एडिट दैट
इंक्लूडिंग कॉर्पोरेट्स आल्सो बिकॉज़ लाइक
इंक्लूडिंग कॉर्पोरेट
टुडे इफ आई वांट टू हैव अ नेटवर्किंग फॉर क्रेडिट रेटिंग एजेंसीज बिकॉज़ दैट इज आल्सो पार्ट ऑफ द रिक्वायरमेंट्स ओवर दैट. Most of the credit rating agencies are private limited companies. So if they can be taken as a corporate entity and then they could be entered into the networking, that could also be very beneficial to all of us.
Yes. So Sanjay, the first instance is basically we wanted to modify the existing guidelines so that people get more encouraged to come together. And this value add will make whole lot of difference to make us move forward in the multidisciplinary practice. So that we'll do it. So okay. This is missed out actually, but very valid point. We'll take it up.
Okay. And the third thing which I wanted to say is that if you see your model A and model B, which has B1 and B2, model A and model B1 is more or less the existing affiliate model which we have, which now you're going to call it as alliance and affiliate, and then you talk about the other aspect of it. Is it that what it is?
No, currently we only have one model which is there. Which
yeah,
is
that is affiliate.
B1.
Yeah.
That is the B1 model. So,
the B1.
Yeah, so now if you see Alliance and B2, three have all the three different characteristics.
So the firms which are already into networking have to re-register now with this new guidance
yes. coming in? They have to go back and tell that which one you want to follow.
Okay, so we'll have to do that.
Yes.
Right, sir. Mr. Chandra Hassan, you could continue, then I'll take up if time permits.
Thank you, Dayanjana Sharmaji, for your informative presentation. My questions are, some of them you referred during deliberations, but still for clarity, I am putting them across to you. Am I audible, Dayanjana Sharmaji?
Sir, it's very low, sir. Just get the mic close.
Okay.
Get the mic close.
Now? Is it okay?
No, no. Take the string close to you.
Yes, sir. Now, is it possible? Audible?
Low, there but low.
Anyway, it is full here now. I can't help anyway. Let me.
No, this is better. This is better.
Okay, right. Globally, networks are not given work, but their combined strength is recognized. Is it a statement in your network guidelines? Now, what is the position in India? You mentioned during deliberation that ICA is putting a proposal to the government for recognition of network firms. What is the status now on that?
Sir, 2 weeks back, we have already shared our detailed deliberation with MCA because MCA is our mother body, correct? So we have already shared it with the Secretary MCA, and Secretary MCA has assured us that he is going to take it forward. That is already on the move, sir. That's already on the move.
Okay, I think hope for the best. The next question is,
sir, why we are hoping for the best, I'll tell you, is only for one reason. We have aligned with the Prime Minister's dream of 100 big firms.
Good. The next question is, you have mentioned in the network guidelines that the networks can themselves form as an AOP and take a PAN number in the income tax. They can also prepare a balance sheet as an AOP. Now, this is it optional or is it mandatory?
Sir, the current thing, I'll tell you, Sanjay bhai, you are aware that example DNS, which is your affiliate network, if I am permitted to use that name.
You can.
So. Yeah, so DNS is only a registration which is done, but it doesn't have any
legal entity.
Correct? So what we have done is we have followed both the models. If you want to register and keep it, which is not an entity, you can have an that way. Or second thing is you can form an AOP also. So both options we have given. Abhi Sanjay bhai, kya ho raha hai? When we are taking work in our existing thing, our network branding is not getting recognized anywhere. So what is happening is if I want to take non-audit services, any consulting and non-audit services, so that I can take it on the name of DSN, DNS and associate if it is an AOP. And I can deliver through AOP, I can raise invoice through AOP, I can distribute that income again back to the respective firm in the format which I have earned the income. So this is something new which has been added.
Just a very value added point, because this was an issue which we had lots of deliberation between our partners. And one more thing, Mr. Daya, I would like to say that I think the two largest network affiliated firms models are from Bangalore itself.
Yes.
And no doubt, what firms are there today in India in affiliate models?
There were 100 network firms, networks which were registered, but the number is not promising at this point in time to even comment.
No, but at least our members would know that that when the competition is less, we add on more numbers.
Sir, I don't think even more than 20 networks exist.
Okay.
Yeah, next question is, you mentioned in the guidelines that ICA will provide a model deed, a template. What is the status of that model deed? Is it available on the website?
Sir, at this point in time, what we have done, if you see this book, we have come out with some guidelines which are already there in this book. what you can have on these guidelines. So we have not drafted a document.
Okay.
Right? No.
Yeah, okay.
If you see, this is already having a lot of information. That set which you want, that is not there, but all the criterias are beautifully put, which you can edit. So just wait for some time, because we did 21 meetings. We were a little.
That's all
Very soon we are going to come out.
That's all right. I think still providing a model deed will help. That's only a suggestion.
Sure.
The next question is, firms might need to have detailed knowledge of other firms to make up their mind so as to with whom they have to go with alliance or networking. Whether these details of the firms is available on the institute's website?
Sir, this is where there are 2 points which I would like to share. Yeah. When you are getting into a networking model, at that point in time, if your firm is aligning with me or my firm is aligning with you,
yeah,
we will be giving you access on the SSP to view what my firm is all about. Point number one. Point number two is, when the new marketplace which we are creating for chartered accountants to come on a single portal, in that also you will get to know about what is the firm's strength internally.
Okay.
So that will be, sir, this is not too far, sir. By end of this year, you will have everything on the table.
Okay. My next question is, this is a hypothetical question to you. Suppose you are a firm of 5 to 10 partners. Between B1 and B2, which model you will choose?
Sir, if you ask me, I'll use the first B1 model, sir.
Not the lead firm model.
No, sir. Because the lead firm model, I'll tell you, the lead firm model has been deliberated from a point of view that, you know, there is a firm which is having an expertise. And there are firms, two partner firms, which are actually willing to align with that model. Like example, if there is a firm which is doing, as I told, mutual fund audits, you know, stockbroker audit, or they might be doing forensic audit, right? So might be my firm is a new firm, which is not as matured as your firm. So what I would like to do is, I'll come to you and say that I would like to come and be associated with you. You will say, why should I actually dilute entire thing? Let me take as a lead firm. You also come and be part of it.
So you mean to say that lead firm is a totally different concept where some expertise is required.
Yes.
Right. My next question is, whether ICI
gets one second, sir, to add to that, Chandra has said, in case of this lead firm networking concept, whether it will be like a merger kind of thing?
No, not at all. Merger is the third stage, madam. That's the third stage.
Actually, the lead type of things could be very useful where you go into one area of practice only of super specialization.
Correct.
That you can take in lots of people and do it across. And since you have the super specialization, you have your systems, that could be a very useful method of doing it across. But if you have a conventional practice, no.
Very rightly put, Sanjay bhai. Actually, example, like we have Dhruva, which is actually an Indian firm which has grown in a very nice manner. Or Transaction Square, which is actually grown in direct taxes only. In your case, your example is GST. So that are all the kind of expertise you have rightly put in. That kind of lead. Some people are only doing public sector banks, right? Or they might be doing national highway corporations, or they might be doing tri-related work. So those firms can actually go for, the B1 model, the B2 model.
And my also advantage would be the CNDG audits of public sector banks as the main statutory auditors. That numbers count a lot, which otherwise you may not be eligible for.
You will not be otherwise eligible for. Might be tens of years also over, some firm will not get an opportunity to work on that.
Okay, my next question is, whether the ICI gets inquiries from the trade bodies or corporates regarding information on big firms or networks firms?
Sir, can you repeat, please?
Whether the ICA get inquiries from trade bodies or corporates on the information about big firms or networking firms, details of such firms?
No, sir. At this point in time, no. Primarily, one very important work which I'm actually working on, Sanjay bhai, again, need your blessing on that, as I take always. I've been made the convener of an exclusive group which is called Financial and Tax Literacy, which is for the first time incorporated to make you know, rather than inward looking, we are now going to look outward, and we are going to create awareness about the chartered accountants at the larger level. So I've been made as a convener, and hopefully 1st July we are launching this. So Chandra sir, hopefully after 1st July, you know, the visibility of a chartered accountant automatically will go up in more than other ways.
Here is my last question, maybe a direct answer or maybe a practical answer, then you, Sharmaji. A networking firm gets the work out of its contacts and reputation, and the work is handed to another network firm in the same group who has to execute the actual work. Now, what may be the ideal formula of sharing the fees? I know that there won't be a golden rule or any practical hint, just want to discuss this.
So we have certain model which is there in our own firm, which we are trying to do it from a different point of view, and we have been successful from last 15 years. So might be sometime, very nice point you have raised. Shetty sir, one request which I have for you, primarily, you know, try to get 4 or 5 firms to come and deliberate how the sharing should happen. Don't do anything else. Let us, I'll be also happy to come and be part of the deliberation where we are going to discuss how models can be think about. Because a lot of people have this gap of thinking. Some people are having a wrong myth in the mind that I have to share 50%, 40%, 60%. No, there is a model. In my office, there is a model which is there. We have preset from the partners, extra our firms, our branches, and everywhere. So what will happen is, if we are able to create a you know, debate kind of thing between 3 or 4 people, I'll be happy to come and share the dais that day to give the answer of this particular question which Chandra sir actually asked.
Thank you.
There are models, sir.
Over to Chairman.
Yeah, thank you. I have a few more questions. One is, the first one is regarding that networking tab which we created in Bangalore branch. You have not told anything about that. I want you to take it across the board.
Yes, sir. I promise you, I am chairman of the member and student services, and all these kind of activities comes under me. Mr. Rajesh Bhalla is going to get in touch with you very soon, sir. And we are going to understand that model, what you have done, and we'll take it forward. If this is going to work out, nothing like it. I can encourage almost all the branches. And I would like to say on the stage that Bangalore has started this thought, which is actually very good recognition for all of us.
I request you to visit our website and see that tab, whether any improvement is required, you please suggest. Then I have a few more questions here. I'll just read out. I think people are waiting for that. Dear sir, it looks like the GST and tax audit numbers are going down. I am a non-corporate COP holder, and now I am planning to come to practice. I have industry experience of about 20 years. Suggest me, what should I do?
Very
simple. Which area he has to concentrate? What avenues? What avenues?
What is his name?
Madhu Appaji. Madhu Appaji.
Okay, Madhu, only one thing which I would like to tell you is, today MSME definition has changed, which is now increased to 250 crores. And Shetty sir, you know that, you know, these companies do not have CFOs, and lot of opportunities they are actually missing out, that MSMEs are missing out. They are not even knowing that, you know, different kind of schemes are available with the government and banks for them. So if you become a virtual CFO in that format, rather than bookkeeping and all, advisory is something which is, when you add value to people's life, then people will be willing to pay you value. As simple as that. The moment you only sign GST and tax audit report, it is a cost for him. But whereas you tell, example, PLI scheme, which has been coming in now, 12 PLI schemes have come. So a lot of pharma companies are there which are requiring that kind of support and guidance, how they need to prepare the document. Lot of state government are giving different kind of initiatives which are there. Every new, the parks are being created, textile park, IT park, this park, that park, and these facilities, people don't even know that there is an announcement made by central government or the state government. You go back and see Niti Aayog site, the number of announcement, number of schemes which are available, might be 1 or 2 people only available, and few thousands of crores are lying with those funds. So you get into that kind of practice rather than getting into direct tax, indirect tax and all. That's my suggestion.
Yes, someone again suggested here. I will just read out for the benefit of others. Thinking out of the box is order of the day. We have to support companies in running their businesses more successfully and profitably by offer management accounting solutions, which our Sanjay ji is going to talk on 18th. Please register for that. You can work on that. Then being a small scale CA firm, how to approach the big fish may not be agreeing to go ahead for this networking approach. How do you take it, sir?
Sorry.
So being a small firm, big firms may not look into them for networking. How do you take it, sir?
No, if you ask me, if I consider myself as a big firm with 10 partners, or Sanjay may consider his firm as a firm, a big firm for 10 partners. If we consider 10 partners, I am interested. I want people to come forward. I cannot grow organically. It is a time where I need to go inorganically only. So there are, see, we are actually perceiving the, you know, our thoughts are with us only. We have never went and explored outside. Please request you to kindly go and explore. Might be out of 10 shots, 3 will be successful. Sanjay bhai has the answer.
No, I think you have to understand that even a small firm can start the networking firm, because if you are one or two people also, you could be a super specialist in a particular area. So you could add a lot of value to many of the firms. So it's not necessary that you have to be a mid-segment or a large firm to basically start the networking. I don't agree with this. Even a small firm can start off, but then you should have some specialization. If I have to join anybody for an affiliation, there should be some super specialization on that.
No, I think this networking is more relevant for that proprietary concerns.
Sir, so one thing I would like to say is basically now these firms have to come together, as rightly said by Sanjay bhai, very nicely hit on nail on the head. But you know why we are thinking every time there is a big firm? That big firm also was a small firm at one point in time, and there are now 10 avenues. Our people are connected with Facebook, LinkedIn, you know, all kind of social media, and today you can actually come together and form a new network which itself will become big.
Yes, another question. Please clarify, can CA holding COP can form a company with his her spouse who is not a CA for corporate form of practice?
Please go back and read that. I have already told, in case of corporate form of practice, you are allowed to do it because of that investment opportunity which is there.
Another question.
Relative definition is as per ICI guideline.
Yes. What about already incorporated company for MDP module? If other institute makes the same precondition that only after approval of you have to register the company, multidisciplinary company practice.
No, sir, you can actually incorporate, you can register yourself as a multidisciplinary firm and later you can add all the people in that. That's not a problem.
Yeah, another question, a chartered accountant who has formed corporate form of multidisciplinary practice, can he continue as partner in audit firm LLP and continue attached function?
The multidisciplinary firm is not something new and different. It is basically one firm in which other people are going to add.
Which module the institute wants to propose?
Which module in the sense? Which model?
Module. You said that there are three modules, no?
B1, B2. Anyone you want to follow, you follow.
Institute propose all the three, whichever you like.
Fits you.
How the networking will benefit women CAs who have proprietary concerns and wants work from home option?
Geeta madam and Divya is there. They can get connected and form a network with them.
I think all other answered.
Yeah. I have one question to ask, the final one, if you permit me, CA Chairman, sir. I know we are running short of time.
Yeah, one last question. Yeah.
You said that the network has to be owned by an Indian CA. What happens to international firms, which many of the CA firms are already networked with?
You want my answer, right?
Obviously. This was not there earlier, if I'm not wrong.
So there is no concept of international network which is actually in place right now, Sanjay bhai. So these international networks ke upar abhi already disciplinary case has been booked for 117 firms because this was not allowed as per the ICI guidelines. So now there is one more thought which is coming up. There are two things. I'll put it this way. I am telling you my thought. To a certain extent, the council members who are with me in this particular discussion, that I'm putting a combined thought. See, what has happened is the international networks were not allowed to operate in India. So that is how the disciplinary actually has been initiated against those firms which have actually been coming into the international network and they have signed some MOUs and agreements. Now the discussion came when we were forming this this networking guidelines. And the beautiful thing, you have actually, I don't know how you get that sixth sense, you actually put me on the dot every time. The answer is, if you remember the point which you raised, the networks should be owned by Indian CA, who is an Indian citizen. The logic is, very nice deliberation by Dheeraj Khandelwal happened. He said, why should I allow Ernst & Young name, KPMG name? Why not I allow ABC, which is my Indian firm? And if they have to come and network with me when I do the international networking approval, they have to align with India and they cannot be naming themselves as KPMG, EY, Deloitte or something. That was a deliberation which was going towards them. So then what we have so told is this branding should be with the Indian firms and Indian firms should be showcased as that is done in China also. There's a new Chinese learning which we had. So in China, they are all Chinese firms whose names are being projected at a larger level. So this is how the, in short background, I'm putting forward.
Nice to know that.
Thank you. So Pannaraj sir, are you there? You have any questions? Pannaraj sir, are you there?
Finland, sir.
Okay. So then initially I told something about our donation request of Bangalore branch regarding oxygen concentrator. We are procuring that and supplying to various our districts of Karnataka. And also we given already 24 to our member of parliament Tejasvi Surya other day, and that request still continues. I request our members to donate generously for that noble cause. Then one more important information I want to share in this, I think a couple of members still exist, more than 200, and to our central council member, Bangalore branch is organizing a GST training program for college faculties, commerce faculties of colleges. So for that program, starting from 17th Monday to Saturday, 6 days continuous online virtual classes are going on. More than 1,000 faculties already registered. Registration is full and we are taking missed opportunities and we are planning to give it on live TV for that. And our Bangalore GST specialists are going to train that. And the registration from across many states, not only from Karnataka, many states and many universities from Karnataka, Andhra, Tamil Nadu, Telugu, Maharashtra, Goa, Madhya Pradesh, and your Telangana. So like that, it is going to be a good program. And our central council member Rajendra Kumar is joining on the inauguration day. And for validatory function, I am looking for a minister, Sanjay ji or Dayanivas ji. Can you arrange our Ashwath Narayan sir for that? He's a deputy chief minister and higher education minister.
He'll come, sir. Don't worry. I think you just reach out to him. He himself will come because they are very positive about this.
No, this is a good program and real true nation builders program. Actually, we are educating the college faculties who they are going to, more than 1,000 we are training, and they are going to impart that knowledge to their students. It's going to be in thousands. So because they introduced this syllabus for post sem BCom students last year, because of pandemic their university not arranged the training program for the faculties. They left out. They approached us and we organized this. This is from Monday, 17, day after tomorrow.
Day after tomorrow.
Yeah, till 22nd.
Just send me a letter from your side to Sanjay bhai as well as me, addressing him about this description. I'll talk to Rajesh Sharma, who is a council member who is from BJP point of view, and I'll see if it can be moved very fast.
Yeah, the letter is ready. In fact, today I made it and sent through somebody to approach him. So from other corner also, if it comes, it is a good program and it can be a good initiative of the ICAI.
Done. And one request which I have to all members, friends, you know, a very humble request. After getting into council only, I realized the importance of CABF. We are actually having very less funds in CABF. Expectation of the members is very high during this pandemic. And you know, last year I made up my mind, was very clear, Shetty sir, that my first expenditure on 1st April will be my membership fees, which is not an expenditure, my investment. And number two, my future investment is basically funding my CABF fund. Every year I have made up on 1st April, the first two payments which I'm going to make is my membership fees and my CABF contribution. Just imagine we are able to pay only, we were pay, able to pay only 7,500 because the funds are short to our members who have unfortunately got deceased and their family was getting, which is raised with great difficulty to 15,000 rupees per month. We are also giving 1,50,000 rupees for the people who are affected with corona. One humble request which I have with each and every one who are attending this program is today, before sleeping, kindly go to CABF, contribute some fund. It is for the benefit. We are contributing, giving donations in left, right, center organizations. But it is time where, you know, CABF fund, I am again a chairman of the member and student services. I never came forward to talk about it, but now we are realizing that, you know, we need to give. Just soncho Sanjay bhai, we are only allowed to, we have only fund to an extent where we are only given, willing to, we are able to contribute 15,000 for a deceased member family. What will happen with 15,000? Nothing. And the kind of earnings we all are doing is much more. I request each one to kindly contribute for CABF also, because it is ultimately going to go for a member's benefit only, who is our brother or sister in the entire fraternity. So I, with folded hand, request from today onwards, start contributing something to the CABF fund, because when I was feeling very bad when anyone was being paid 15,000 rupee check, or a poor student who's been paid, you know, the scholarship, we are not able to give them what we can give. And the fraternity is so rich in more than one ways that, you know, we can't imagine. So it is humble request to all to contribute for CABF and ensure that, you know, that money, and the beauty about that is, it is, though it is a fund, is society registered in the ICAI, but it is monitored by an independent body. And there is no single expenditure which has been booked. Entire cost is taken by ICAI. Just imagine that. And the people who approve this CABF payment to be made to the needy people is not by any other person, but they are independent people of past and very senior people.
Thank you, Dayavai. And this, I am Pannara speaking.
Yeah.
I was sorry, I was on another call, important call, when I missed it, when you called me, Shetty sir. But one request from the Southern, this one, to Central Council member, that most of the young chartered accountants have just entered into practice. There is a request from them to either waive or defer their membership fee. I think last time also that this one was raised. Is there any deliberation at center or center council?
Next week we have the council meeting. But yeah, actually what happens, Pranarat sir, this is as per the act that you need to charge a fees. So if there is any change which is there, we need to change the act. And that is actually a challenge.
I see. So, and otherwise, is there any provision for deferring the fee without removing the name of the name from the register for next year?
Sir, no, that is also not available in the act, sir. Because we are driven with an act. We are,
I know,
we cannot actually
move.
I know.
Second was there. Second option must be there. That was my called expectation.
In fact, it is basically, there is a specific clause which is there in the CA Act, which talks about the payment which is going to be membership fees falls due on 1st of April.
Yeah.
And that need to be paid by 30th June or 30th September maximum.
Yes.
And there is a timeline. If the membership fees is not paid, annual membership fees is not paid, the name of the member should be removed from the register of members. So if you have to change the law, it is change of law. You cannot even defer because it says you need to take the money.
Just for information, I think this CABF contribution from SARC is always good. Even I saw in our Bangalore branch percentage wise, their question is for award thing, 5% whether 5% of members contributed for CABF. If I calculated that percentage is much higher. And in fact, during our Kotha Srinivas was SARC chairman, he collected more than 1.5 crore for the CABF. Yes. It was a great achievement. So, so I think we are generous in that matter, but I think it needs further contribution also. Our member, see this month, future all 3-4 programs of Bangalore branch is free of cost. You are going to structured CP also. So it is my humble request, one for that COVID purpose, which we already requested, sent mail also today also, and for CABF. If you are not contributing there, at least contribute to CABF, whatever the amount. Yes, I think above 500 is acceptable there, or 500 or 5 lakhs or whatever, up to you. My humble request to contribute, because we are not charging. These are all actually, see, wealth management is 400 rupees we are charging. I'm just thinking, because all these requests we are making, that also we'll remove that. Whoever already paid will refund, and we'll do all the this month because of pandemic free. That wealth management is outside market. It is 10,000 cost worth, minimum 10,000 worth program. That is, we proposed 400. That also we will waive it off for our members. Kindly, once again, our humble request, contribute to anywhere, whichever is possible, amount to CABF or our COVID purpose. Okay, with that I think thank you once again, Dayaji. And I request our branch secretary to propose form a lot of thanks. Thank you very much to all the panelists.
Thank you.
Thank you, Chairman. Dear members, I take this occurrence on behalf of Bangalore branch of SIRC of ICA to propose formal vote of thanks for today's program. Wholehearted thanks to our Central Council member, C.A. Dayanivash Sharma sir, for sparing his valuable time and giving an excellent presentation. Thank you so much, sir, on behalf of all the participants and the entire Managing Committee of Bangalore branch and all the members, sir. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much once again. I also thank all our panelists, CA Sanjay Dariwal, sir, Chandrahas, sir, Geeta ma'am, Panrat, sir, for joining today's program and making it a very special program. Though it was in a last minute, we requested all of you. You were all kind enough to accept our request. Thank you so much, all of you. And I request all of you to kindly stay safe and be healthy. Thank you so much. All the participants, I thank you very much. Today we have crossed 500 participants for today's program. I thank all of you for your active participation, and I request once again all of you to kindly adhere to our chairman's request and support us what best you can do for the transformational agenda we had kept for supplying more and more of oxygen concentrators to the needy people. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, all of you.
Thank you. Good night.
Thank you, Chairman, sir. Thank you, Sanjay.
Good night.
Thank you.
Thank you all, sir. Thank you all.